Apple is changing its approach to software in big ways, possibly to compete with Google, Facebook, Amazon's, and the developer community as a whole. Today's WWDC keynote showcased three major themes from Apple: new, simple, and repeatable design experiences, making Apple devices uniform and connected, and opening traditionally Apple-controlled tools like Siri, Messenger, and Maps to the developer community. WatchOS, OS X, iOS, and tvOS all received updates today, so let's dive right in. Starting with WatchOS. Today, Apple announced a new UI and faster app launching. The third version of WatchOS is all about speed. According to Apple, it is 7 times faster than the previous OS. To help you navigate faster, Apple added a dock. Just swipe up to quickly launch different apps. WatchOS 3 will also have a control center like on iOS. You can swipe up and see quick commands like mute, Bluetooth, and Wi-Fi on and off. There are also a few new watch faces, including one with Minnie Mouse and one with numerals. On to OS X. OS X is getting a new name, Mac OS, with the current version dubbed Sierra. As expected, this new version of Mac OS will finally bring support for Siri to the desktop. Siri will be able to help you find files on your Mac, send messages, and perform tasks while you're using other apps in full screen mode. Speaking of Siri, today Apple finally opened its voice assistant to third-party developers. A quick, "Hey Siri," now works with Slack, WhatsApp, Twitter, Yelp, Runkeeper, Venmo, and potentially many, many more. Also new to Mac OS is Auto Unlock, which automatically unlocks your Mac when your iPhone or Apple Watch is close to it, which will be super helpful for Apple Pay, which is coming to the web this fall. Mac users will be able to pay online in Safari using a Pay with Apple Pay button and authenticate their purchases using Touch ID on their phone or watch. Apple is also adding improved support for iCloud Drive. With this update, you can easily move older files to the cloud to free up space on your local machines. If you use multiple Mac OS machines, Apple will now sync your desktops. The new OS will be available as a free upgrade to all OS X, now Mac OS users, this fall. Now, let's talk about all the software upgrades to your iPhone or iPad with the new iOS 10. An update we've all been waiting for. Users can now send each other rich links, meaning music or videos can be played directly within a conversation. Thanks to opening up the platform to third-party developers, integrations will range from sending videos and GIFs to paying friends with SquarePay or collaboratively ordering food from DoorDash. There's also been a big overhaul to the Photos app in iOS 10. Apple is making it easier to find and group your images. The new photo app groups your library into editable movie memories. Maps has been redesigned, adding proactive suggestions, a new turn-by-turn look, and is now also open to third-party developers. Apple Music has been simplified in a major redesign, and with the new Apple Home, all HomeKit-enabled devices, from lights to thermostats to garage doors, can be controlled from a single app. A small shakeup today is that Apple is unbundling its native apps like Mail, Maps, and Music to put them in the App Store. This means these apps will be updated more often instead of only when there's a major iOS release, allowing for quicker updates and the ability to add new features, fix bugs, and address security issues as soon as they happen. iOS 10 also offers some new lock screen and 3D touch shortcuts that help you get all the info you need quicker. iOS 10 is available in public beta this summer and rolls out in the fall. As far as Apple TV, tvOS had some minor updates to the operating system, gaining a deeper Siri integration and single sign-on options. To recap, with no new devices announced, today marked a huge software overhaul for Apple. With deeper integration of Siri and new marching orders to improve by collaboration on the software side moving forward.